Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be talking about some case studies related to management. Now, as you all know that management holds majority of the weightage when it comes to finance and management syllabus. In fact, 45 to 50% of the entire paper is created out of management in both RBI as well as SEBI examinations. Therefore, it's important that you understand what kind of case studies can be asked in the examination and how to approach these case studies. So I'm going to be solving both these problems today, the types of case studies that can be created and asked from you and how to approach these case studies, how to get to the right answer or the most optimum answer. So let us start with the session with our first case study. Now you can pause this video for a while, read the entire case study, because if I start reading it, it's going to take a lot of time. And then I will tell you what are the keywords that you should not have missed before jumping to the answer, jumping to the question that will be asked based on this case study. The case study is on motivation. Just pause the video for a while and read the entire case study. Now, these are the keywords that you should have highlighted and you have to highlight when you're actually reading case studies in the examination. So you will have it on the internet, on a laptop, so you cannot actually highlight them out there, but you can anyways either write them down somewhere or the other in your rough sheet, or you can try and remember that, okay, these are the areas which are important, I have to keep them in mind. The points are the personal objectives of the employees are also fulfilled. So this case study is about motivation, wherein a person is trying to motivate, a manager is trying to motivate his employees through by following the Maslow's motivational theory. Okay, so the personal objectives of the employees as well as the professional objectives of the employees, both of them are fulfilled. Shivam is an employee who wants a life, who wants to live a secure life. So this is our first keyword here. He wants to live a secure life, which becomes a safety need, in which he and his family of three are meeting the basics of life. Basics of life means physiological need, that is the first need. For Shivam, security of job is of prime importance, again safety need, since he cannot afford to lose his job with the responsibility of his family. His dream at the same time is also to hold a managerial position in the organization, and the purpose of holding managerial position is to gain some esteem in the organization, to gain some status in the organization. Okay, now let us have a look at the question that can be asked from this particular area. The question is, in which of the following categories aspirations of Shivam fall as per the Maslow's need hierarchy theory? What all needs are being given importance by Shivam? That is the gist of the question. Self-actualization, esteem, belongingness and love needs, safety needs and physiological needs. So if you look at Maslow's need hierarchy theory, you will see that it starts with physiological needs, then moves on to safety needs, then belongingness and social needs, then you have esteem needs, and the final needs are self-actualization needs. Okay, now self-actualization, esteem, both of them are psychological needs. Belongingness needs are also psychological needs, whereas safety needs and physiological needs are completely physiological needs. There is no psychology involved there or minimal psychology involved there. Okay, now which are the following needs are given importance by Shivam? He directly talks about safety needs, so that is certainly our answer, one of our answers. He directly talks about the basic needs, right, which makes it clear that physiological needs are important for him. Now the confusion where a lot of students are going to make a mistake is that he talks about his dream becoming a manager in the organization. Okay, now it is his dream to hold managerial position in the organization, which is not a self-actualization need, which a lot of us might think, but it is an esteem need. Therefore, our answer is 2, 4 and 5. Esteem need, physiological need and safety need. So, our answer here is C. Let us now come to the second question. The second question here is Gandalf Included is a company. So, it's about Gandalf Included. Which is a company which deals with providing car services. Please pause the video and read the entire case study which you have here. Okay, and then I will be highlighting the key points for you. Now, I'm assuming that you've gone through the entire case study. So let me highlight the key points for you. The key points here are, number one, however, with the passing of time, the size of the company has grown and now there are many branches of this company. So the company has grown, the size of the company has grown and there are many branches. This means there are a lot of departmental heads of all the departments or all the branches. Now, the departmental heads of the company are specialists in their respective areas and the top management tries to work with them, not with authority, this is a keyword here, but by respecting their views, because their ego clashes are might go up and therefore they want to avoid, in order to avoid these ego clashes, the top management deals with departmental heads, not with authority, but by respecting their views. Now, the question that can be asked from this is, which of the following concepts has been highlighted in the case study? Which of the following concepts has been highlighted in the case study? Cooperation, coordination, planning, and motivation. Okay, I want you to answer this question for yourself before I explain to you what is the difference between the key terms here and why one of the key terms is not as you might believe to be the answer, but why the other one is the correct answer. Now, planning, it can be completely eliminated because in this entire case study, we are not talking about planning at all. We are completely talking about totally talking about the level of or the relationship between the top management and the departmental heads. So, TMNDH, the relationship between them is the point of discussion. Motivation, is the top management anyways trying to motivate the departmental heads? Is that the point of discussion? No, that is not. They are trying to ignore or avoid is a better word. They are trying to avoid the ego clashes that they might have with the departmental heads. Okay, so these two are completely out, can be eliminated. Now, the discussion or the confusion will be between cooperation and coordination. The correct answer for this is coordination and not cooperation, and let me explain to you the reason that I have mentioned here, that I have highlighted here. Coordination is an orderly arrangement of efforts to provide unity of action. Orderly arrangement of efforts. The main difference between coordination and cooperation, the main difference is that this is an organized method and a formal method and an orderly arranged method, a very well planned method of efforts in order to create the right sync between people or between departments in the organization. Whereas cooperation, on the other hand, is the willingness of individuals to help each other. Therefore, this is informal in nature. This is not so organized. So, this is disorganized in nature. And there is no effort by the organization to arrange different departments, arrange different people in such a form, in such a way that they are able to coordinate with each other. They are able to cooperate with each other. Okay. Therefore, the answer in this case, because this has been done by the organization deliberately, therefore, this becomes coordination and not cooperation. I hope you have understood this. Let's come to the third one. Now, this is a big case study and we're going to have two questions from this case study. I believe this is the one. Yes. So, I would like you to pause this video for a while, read this entire page, and then I will move to the other page, where the important key points or keywords have been highlighted. So, I hope you have gone through this case study by reading this. Let's go to the next page. We have the remaining part of the case study. As I said, it's going to be a long case study. Now, here are the keywords. Fran looked over the form and said casually, so you want to post for the executive secretary job in branch management division. And to which Judy replies that it is, yes, it is graded as a 14, and which is 2 grade higher than my job, that makes my job as a graded 12. Judy here is still talking, and she's saying, I'm always busy. I don't see why I should work in a job graded at a 12 and work twice as hard and yet not be paid the same as that secretary. So it is she's talking about her hard work here. And she's also talking about the pay that she's receiving. The next line, wherein you have some keywords, is you think you should be paid more for the work you do and you want, and that you want to switch jobs. So this is the reply of Fran, because she's trying to confirm whether what she's understood from Judy's response is correct or not. The case study still continues. Please go through it. The keyword here is did require additional background experience, skills and responsibilities. This is the response of Fran to herself. She's thinking about it. She's obviously not talking to Judy about it. She's thinking that the post that Judy is comparing her post with does require more experience, more skills and more responsibilities. Therefore, Judy is not thinking straight or thinking correctly when she's trying to compare her present job with the job where an opening is available. Okay, so this is the case study. I hope you've gone through it. You can pause it anytime, go back and go through the case study again. Now let's have a look at the question. The question says, which of the following motivational decisions should Fran take? Motivational decisions, keyword here, should Fran take in order to retain Judy in her present department working as secretary to Fran? Options are A, since Judy is only concerned about money, Fran can satisfy her physiological need to retain her in the present department. Is Judy only concerned about money? No, she talked about the post as well. 14 grade compared with the 12 grade. Therefore, this is incorrect. Since Judy is comparing her work status and perks with another department within the organization, that is correct. Yes, she is comparing her work. She is working harder. Status 14 versus 12 and perks, yes, she's talking about pay. Fran has to ensure equity among the compared jobs in order to retain Judy in the present job. This looks right, so let's keep it aside. Since Judy is only considered about position grade 12 versus grade 14, Fran should talk to the top management and get Judy's present job graded 14. Now this is not possible because in the case study itself it was mentioned in the last slide that Fran was thinking about it. And she came to the conclusion that the 14 graded job does require more experience, more responsibility, more skills, and therefore she cannot do this. Since Judy is acting in an amateur manner and not understanding small differences between her job and the new job, Fran should make her understand that Judy is not capable or qualified enough to be able to work as an executive secretary. Should you be doing that to your employee? If your employee is coming to you, should you be telling him or her that he or she that you are not capable or qualified enough? Instead, you have to try and talk him or her out of it in a more diplomatic yet motivational or in a positive manner. Therefore, the best option that we have here is B. I hope you got to the right answer. There is another question based on this case study. As I said, we'll be discussing two questions here based on this case study. The question is, the following are reasons given by Judy for wanting to post for a position in another department. Which among the following points are or is or are debatable? So which among the following points are debatable? Which means that which of the following points are incorrect in some or the other form. Okay. Her recent merit increase was not adequate enough reward for her hard work. This is what she feels. There is an open position that would pay almost twice than what she is making now. She has heard that the job in question is easier to do than the one she has now. She wants to get an easier, higher paying job by moving to the new position. Now, D is certainly right. She does want to get an easier and higher paying job. C is right. She has heard. Yes, she has heard that the job in question is easier to do. A is right. Yes, her recent merit increase, according to her, was not adequate enough. But we certainly wrong. In the case study, nowhere is mentioned that there is an open position that would pay almost twice. It says that it would be paying more because it is graded 14 compared with 12 grade of the present job that Judy has, but it is not going to pay twice. So it's a factual question, an easy question if you have read the case study very well. If you have missed out on the facts, if you have missed out on the important keywords, you have not highlighted them, then you will get confused in this question. Okay. Now let's talk about the last case study for today. Please pause the video and go through the entire case study for yourself. Now these are the keywords. It's about James, Washington and Dorothy, wherein Dorothy has been an assistant manager at Northview for over 12 years and was more than twice of James' age, and Dorothy was resisting his taking over leadership of the service center. So it's mentioned here that Dorothy is twice age of James, and at the same time it is mentioned that Dorothy is resisting the takeover of leadership of the service center for various reasons. Let's have a look at the question which can be asked on this. The question is, which of the following is the main reason behind Dorothy's revolt against James' managerial role? So there are four options. I will be discussing the four options one by one. I want you to answer this question first in your head or in the comment section below. Pause it and then I will answer it for you. Dorothy does not value positional authority because she is the most experienced and knowledgeable when it comes to managing the service center. So the keywords here are, Dorothy does not value positional authority. Dorothy wants to be manager of the service center herself, and thus wants to push out every manager that is appointed by Northview till she is appointed. James is very young compared with Dorothy, so Dorothy feels embarrassed and incapable in front of James. Dorothy wants an experienced manager who she can work with effectively. She feels that young managers are often inexperienced and amateurs. She wants to prove her point by challenging James and recording his reactions for the management to see. In the entire case study, she has never talked about experience. In the entire case study, she has never talked about her feeling incapable or embarrassed. In the case study, she has not talked about that she wants to be the manager of service center. But yes, it is very clear that she does not value positional authority because she is continuously, consistently challenging the authority of James over her, right? So she's consistently, as you can see here, James Washington was a young graduate, so he is young, and she has challenged it. How she has challenged it? Here, to James' astonishment, one day after the store had closed, she brought out a portable television and placed it on her desk, intending to watch it. So in this way, she is challenging the positional authority of James. Therefore, the main reason behind Dorothy's revolt is that she is not valuing the positional authority of James. That means our answer in this case is A. The case studies are very similar to what I have asked here today. Therefore, I would request you to prepare these kinds of case studies on your own or through the YouTube channel, through this series that I have carried out, that I have started, wherein I am going to be discussing a lot of case studies of management with you. Me and Srishti both might be doing this in order to help you out with as many case studies as possible. I will also be creating some more questions based on the same case studies, and then we will move forward and talk about more new cases as well, so that you know, okay, these are the kinds of questions that can be created from these case studies. This is the way I have to approach management. That way is, whatever material you are following, whatever methods you are following in order to go through management will be more effective in nature. Okay, this was all for today's lesson. If you like this lesson, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and provide me your feedback in the comment section below. If you need something else, if you want me to prepare videos of some other kind, if you want me to create videos of some other topic which you specifically feel that you're not confident in, anything that you need, your feedbacks will be valued, and I will try and find out time in order to create more such lessons. Till then, all the very best. Take care. Bye-bye.